Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma's Mega Music Reaction Fest 2, and we are going to give our reaction to Metallica, and this time it is for the Frayed Ends of Sanity. This is for our patron Ajay, and it looks like it is from the album And Justice for All. We have given several reactions to Metallica by now. One of the most favorite ones of ours has been Orion. Then Rise of Atlas. Then we started our journey.
Atlas Rise.
Yeah, Atlas Rise. And then our journey began with Metallica with this song One, which really was thought provoking.
There have been several great songs that we have reacted to, masterpieces in metal, for sure. Whether it's One, whether it's Master of Puppets, whether it's Orion, whether it's Atlas Rise.
Creeping Death is a recent one that we have done, then Damage INC, Sanitarium. Wow.
Yeah, our list is more than a dozen reactions long now. I think this is the 15th or 16th reaction of Metallica that we are doing, and it's I guess the second or third most that we have reacted to on Cafe Enoma. The second
or band
or artist overall, you know, and that shows that how popular Metallica is on our channel, how immensely popular they must be on YouTube, and how incredibly popular they are world over. So this is something I think I will connect with instantly. If the title is what the song is about, then definitely as a counselor and psychotherapist, this is something that it should be easy for me to decipher. But of course I need to listen to it and understand it first to decipher it. But definitely it's something that I'm interested in. It's a Patreon request by a guy named Ajay. So something tells me he's either Indian or he has Indian origins. So it should be interesting why he's asked us to react to it, whether he knows our background, that we are counselors, and I'm a counselor and psychotherapist, and that's why he's asked us to react to it, or it's just a request of a song that he likes.
Yeah.
So either way, let's get started. It should be really interesting. And we know it's Metallica, so obviously it's going to be a great song, nevertheless. So it's all about our reaction, how good our reaction is to it.
Yes.
The song is already great.
So Ajay, welcome to our channel and let's begin.
Never hunger, never trust her. I am falling prey to failure.
start. Is a god on those drums. He's not just the founder of Metallica, he is 40% of Metallica, I would say. Because the drums are so pivotal in the sound that we hear in every single song that we react to of Metallica. The drums are important, the bass guitaring is so important, and of course the vocals and lead guitaring, but mainly it's the drums. You know, how rarely do you get that in a rock band or a heavy metal band, where you talk about the drummer. And the interplay between the drummer and bass guitarist, you know, is just phenomenal. It's heavenly. It's just breathtaking to listen to. It is something that it's like a miracle, you know, putting those two together, the bass guitarist and the drummer. Something
I think
this
Metallica
magical.
Has the best pair of drummer and the bass guitar.
Best pair I've heard.
Yeah. The chemistry, the kind of tuning that they have and when they play is rare to find. And they go on for a long stretch. It's not like, you know, most of it is filled with the lead guitar and other things. Most of Metallica songs are of the drum and the bass guitar. And there comes in the solo, which will be lasting only for a minute or less sometimes. Or maybe within 2 minutes it gets over, the lead guitar bit.
When you are suffering from schizophrenia, one of the problems that you will face is that you have a lot of illusions. You know, you will imagine things and you will also start to forget things. And it happens with such frequency as the intensity of the disorder becomes more and more severe. It will start to happen more frequently, that you will forget things, and to replace whatever you've forgotten, I've seen people start making things up for what they've forgotten. You know, so whatever I've seen in my experience as a psychotherapist and counselor, I've seen that the patients and the clients who come in with such an issue, they imagine things. They think people are calling out to them. They think people are sitting with them, talking to them. They think people are giving them assignments to do. If you see Beautiful Mind, it is shown so beautifully, the Russell Crowe star. You will see over there that he imagines that the government of USA has given him an important secret assignment to do.
Yeah.
You know, so his whole life or part of his life revolves around completing those secret assignments. And it's all happening in his brain most of the time. But due to that, his behavior changes too. So the same goes with others who suffer from schizophrenia. You know, any disorder, mental disorder, where you're having illusions, where you are forgetting things, and when you're having manic episodes, which cause you to be depressed, which cause you to be, you know, disconnected from the outside world. And you can sense all of that in the lyrics here. Metallica must have done phenomenal research to put together a song of this level. To make things fit together so beautifully that whether a layman listens to it or a counselor like me with a lot of experience, we can easily understand what they're trying to say. So it's very beautifully researched, it's beautifully composed, it's well, beautifully arranged. I'm sure if there was a music video for this one, it must make a lot of sense and tie up to the lyrics and the music beautifully. Knowing Metallica, I'm sure they've done that. Many times people say we should have reacted to the official video. For example, for one, we get that often. But the fact is, that is not our job as a reactor. I don't want to be one of those reactors who just looks at a music video and reacts to what I see. If that's the case, I don't think, you know, I'm fit to be a reactor. On Enoma, it's quite different what we do. And I think people who appreciate our reactions, even if it's 1,000, 2,000 of them for each reaction that we do, I think those who appreciate them, definitely they understand why we are doing this. We are doing something which nobody else wants to do. Nobody else wants to sit down. Don't get me wrong. Nobody else actually wants to sit down and listen to a song like this and give a detailed analysis of what the lyrics mean to them or what they understand of the lyrics. Nobody wants to do that. People just want to say, overreact on the music, talk about it for a while, say that the lyrics were good. The lyrics were good. The lyricism was good.
Lyricism.
What was so good about the lyrics, my friend? Isn't that your job as a reactor to tell people what you have understood of those lyrics? And so I don't believe in shallow reactions. I don't believe in impure reactions. I don't believe in overreacting. And that's why we get less views. And so be it. Because my job is as a counselor, I want to enrich my life. I want to enrich my job. I want to enrich my qualities as a counselor and human being when I react to music. This song is beautiful. This song is absolutely beautiful because it tells you, it gives you great insight into the mind of a schizophrenic person. You may not know that person directly, but after listening to this song, trust me, when you look around you, one out of four people that you know, and that one out of four may be you, if it's not the other three. One out of four people that you know is schizophrenic in today's world. And by that I mean they show symptoms of what was mentioned in the lyrics. They believe people are calling them. They believe people are speaking to them. They have illusions about various things. They believe they are on secret assignments. They believe they are out to make a difference. And they believe they are, you know, lots of things. And most of those things are imaginary. Whenever they forget things, they fill up those gaps with imaginary things. If you see your defragmentation software on your computer or laptop, or even on your mobile phone, I don't know if they have one now, but on your computer or laptop, if you see how it works, you'll feel it, you know, you'll see different colors to start with, and then all those colors, whether it's pink, green, yellow, all those colors become one color, which is either pink, green, or yellow. So all those colors eventually become pink. Let's say they all become pink. So they start with various fragments of pink, green, yellow, and sometimes there's a black dot, which means that that part is damaged or there's a virus there. So, but everything is pink, green, or yellow mostly. But towards the end of the defragmentation process, everything is pink or green, depending on the color that you've chosen, or it's automatically set up by that particular software. So the same goes with the mind of a human being, and more so with the mind of a schizophrenic person. what happens is that when they have their schizophrenic episodes, they have pink, green, yellow, blue too. They have different colors inside their brain. You know, it's arranged just like that defragmentation software. It's all scattered all over the place. Pink, green, yellow, blue. And that disturbs them. That disturbs them seriously. They may go into a panic attack mode. They may become stressed out. They may start crying. They may start banging walls. They may start banging their head on the walls. They will go crazy. So, because they don't like those different colors inside their brain. So, what they try to do is, on their own, the brain, you know, tries to calm things down by converting all those different colors into one color, whether it's pink, green, blue, etc. You know, usually it turns into all black. And that shows that the person is in severe depression and is in, you know, it's borderline. It's on the verge of possibly ending their life or ending somebody else's life or doing a lot of damage, serious damage. So basically what they try to do is a schizophrenic person tries to fill in these gaps, you know, by creating imaginary colors. So they imagine different things happening to them. Say if they are living alone, and this usually tends to happen, in my experience I've seen it happen with people who lost a pet if they are living just with a pet, with people who lost their partner if they're just living with the partner, with people who are living alone. It happens more with these three sets of people. What happens is they start filling in those gaps, they start converting those colors to one color. So they start imagining a lot of things happening to them. They start imagining a person talking to them every day. They start imagining a cook coming into the kitchen cooking food for them. They start imagining speaking to the cook saying, please add some salt to this. Please add some pepper to this. Please add some capsicum. I love capsicum. I love green peppers. Please chop some and add them. They actually imagine all this happening in front of them because that's what they want to happen. It's not happening actually, but in their vivid imagination at that point of time, it's happening. And that's what Metallica is talking about here so vividly, so beautifully. That's all that I have to say really. This is a masterpiece for anyone who's as mature enough or experienced enough as a counselor or human being to have dealt with someone who's going through this. Are you sure you'll get how beautiful this has been when you listen to it and read those lines on the screen? What are your thoughts, Kirti? Just 2-3 minutes, I'm sorry. But what are your thoughts? And in fact, we are out of time, but for people to hear your point of view, whatever it may be, next 4 minutes are yours.
Okay, thank you. For me, the song is dealing with whether you call it frayed ends of sanity or insanity, whichever comes first, you know, ends are going to meet somewhere at one point and become one. The whole edge is going to be the same color as you're giving them colors. And the song is dealing with majorly three terms, I would say. First one is schizophrenia, second one is dementia, and third one is paranoia. All of them are also parts of each other. Somebody who has dementia can have episodes of schizophrenia a little bit. Somebody who's suffering from severe paranoia will show more than 3, 4, 5 disorders at one time. Yeah. Paranoid people can have many, many disorders working on them at several times. They may not know what is. I like the line where he says, fighting the fear of fear is the biggest example of paranoia. You're fighting the fear of fear. You don't even know what is going to happen. You don't even know what is it, but you do fear that fear. And you're constantly trying to stay away from it, trying to push it, trying to escape it. That may not be there, but your fears at times take over you so much that you keep fighting them again and again and again, which makes you a different person altogether, which makes your mind delusional. It makes you, you know, hallucinate, think about things which is not even happening. Same happens in schizophrenia. You have first-hand experience of it. I too do. But, you know, schizophrenia or paranoia or dementia, the angles or the impact of it is more on the sides of a personality which has been dominant in that person when that person was normal. I don't know if you guys get that, what I'm trying to say. So let's give an example. If the person, a normal person like me, who has a side which is very dominant of some trait of mine. As in just give an example, I'm very insecure. But that's not a problem at the moment when I'm normal. But that's one of the sides that I have. That I'm a bit insecure. I get insecure at times. And you know, that makes me disturbed. That makes me troubled. What happens when we do get schizophrenia? That side becomes very dominant. And when we have the episodes, when we are imagining, when we are making up things, when we are hallucinating, we keep thinking that people are scheming against me. There is whole world out to get me. I have to do something against it, to fight it. So it's the episode of paranoia, it's the episode of schizophrenia, it's the attack of insecurity, everything attacking your brain at that time, and you're trying to do something to avoid that altogether. And that's when the insane things happen. Bands like Metallica always have been doing a service when they take up songs like this. I like those separate words done together, you know, commas, said life, death, and things like that. It reminded me of the song that we gave a reaction to of Metallica. I'm very bad at remembering names, but about Mother Earth. So this completes the song. Wow.
Yeah, and I always think it's a shame that reviewers, reactors, and the like on this particular platform and other platforms too do not appreciate the lyrics of Metallica, and they do not dig deep into it. I don't know what they are so hesitant about. Maybe they feel their lack of awareness will be caught. Maybe they feel they cannot understand it at all, so why try it out? But it's a real shame, because the true genius of Metallica lies not just in its music, but in its lyrics. And unfortunately, most fans, reviewers, and for per se all the people who listen to Metallica in their lifetime never actually get down to the lyrics. So that's a shame. I mean, Metallica would be almost twice as popular as they are today if people actually understood how great their lyrics are. And this is a perfect example of that. This is a song unheard of. I've never heard of it. I've heard a few songs of Metallica. We have reacted to 15, I think, now. I've never ever heard of it before today. That just shows, and I've listened to 7,000-8,000 songs. Most of them rock music, heavy metal. So if I've not heard this, it shows that people even don't even acknowledge it as a big hit of Metallica. That's sad. That's really, really sad. That's it for this one. If you like the way we react to music, and I'm assuming since you watched this far, you do.
Yeah.
You can check out our Patreon page, read our profile, and request a reaction if there's an tire available right now. Goodbye.
Thanks for watching.